Hey guys, good morning everyone. How are you today? The final day in 2019. Glory to God. God has been good. How many of you are grateful? If you're grateful, can you type I am grateful? You can also type thank you, Jesus. I am grateful. I don't know about you, but I'm super duper, duper, looper, rupu grateful to see the last day in 2019. It's not everybody who started this year that is ending it alive. God is good. I want to share with you a powerful thing I've never shared before. Three things that moved me from poverty to wealth. And I know that if you try it, you will experience the same. Three things that moved me from poverty to wealth. It's going to be a very short video because I'm going to the office. You see, part of what I taught you, rich people still work during holidays. Okay, we're still hustling. We dey hustle. Some of you that I just enjoy. If I grow up, I want to be like some of you. By the way, share this video. Click on the Facebook party and invite all your friends. Share this video. This is the last day in the year 2019. One of the best gifts you can give me is to have 500 people watching this video. It's going to be a very short video, but it will be a good gift. I'll be grateful if you can do that. How do you do that? Just share, copy the link, paste it on Facebook, WhatsApp group, LinkedIn group. Three things that I did. Good morning, everybody. Remember to tell me your name and your city as you're joining us. I can see a whole lot of you here. Ikena is here. Leah is grateful. Oh, Ikena is grateful. Good to know that you guys are grateful. God has been good. Prince Marking is grateful. Say good morning, boss. Prince, how are you today? Good to see you. Your name and the city you're joining me from. I like to know your name and your city. Now, three things that move me from poverty to wealth is what I want to share. I need you to know that success is not by mistake. If your success will last, you know what you did. You know what changed your story. Lord, if you be afraid of a man who didn't know how he made it, because he will soon lose the success. Olajumoke, okay, good to see you. Says I'm grateful. Stanley Eze, how are you? Good to see all of you. Be wary of somebody who became successful without knowing how, without knowing what he or she did. Because, quote me, Joe, good to see you. That person will soon lose that success. Every truly successful person know what they did. I want to share three of such things that I did that moved me from poverty to wealth. How many of you are interested? If you are interested, can you type I'm interested? Come on, talk to me. Are you interested in learning the three things that I did that moved me from poverty to wealth? By the way, for your information, I was born poor. My mother was a civil servant. My father was a businessman whose business had collapsed before I was born. I grew up in the northern part of Nigeria. I learned how to spell the word TH in Jesus 1. I had a very terrible education. Okay? Nobody in my lineage has ever traveled out except my father, who was sent by the federal government on pilgrimage to Israel. Okay, there is no year I don't travel to more than 40 cities. This year alone, I was outside this country for more than 7 months, traveling to different countries. I have broken generational barriers. What nobody has ever done in my family, I did them. Okay, and I wasn't born rich, and there's no godfather anywhere except God who will tell you he or she was responsible for where we are today. No godfather anywhere except God. God did it all. And so my story can change anybody else's life, and it's something you should listen to because there's so much lesson in it. Okay, I like you again. Like I said, share this video as many times as you can. I can see many of you joining. Ikena is interested. Eze is interested to know what I did. Pastor Daniel Mewa from Benin is interested. Good to see all of you. Charisma Noble is interested. Thank you, everybody. Share this video right now. copy this link, paste it on all your WhatsApp group, paste it on your Facebook group. I'd like you to click on that icon, the Facebook party icon, and start inviting all your friends. The best gift you can give me is that we have 500 people watching this video. And if all of you, the 100 people watching, share this video 5 times, that's all I need. If all of you share this video 5 times, we will have 500 people watching now. If everybody watching now decide to share 5 times, we have 500 people. It won't cost you anything to do it. It's not going to cost you more data by sharing. You rather change this world. You make this world better. You teach somebody something. You help somebody who will run with what I'm teaching today for their life. Based on all your Facebook group, all your WhatsApp group, all your LinkedIn group, click on the Facebook party icon now. Do it now. Do it right away. Don't procrastinate. It's probably one of the good things you will do in 2019, for me at least. Abi, I'm a rich man, there's a few things you can give me, but sharing this video 5 times will get us 500 viewers, and I'll be grateful if you can do that. The first thing I did that moved me, okay, everybody is ready, so let's go into it. The first thing I did that moved me from poverty to wealth is called the principle of determination. I got to a point one day, and I will share this story with you because it changed my life. One day I was with a friend who had started learning how to build wealth. But I got close to him, we were in the same church. And there was this big car that passed. I was still a student then. And I said to him, I said, I don't know what all these people did to have all this money. You know, we don't even know. Probably he's a thief now that was able to buy this kind of big car. And my friend said, never say that word again. Not everybody that is rich is a thief. That's what my friend said. He said, if you are determined enough, you can be that successful. You can have this kind of big cars, be this wealthy. But if you begin to think everybody who is wealthy probably stole the money, you've cut yourself away from wealth. That's what my friend said to me. So I pick up that determination that day. I'll never forget that if there is a legal way to become rich, I will become rich using that legal way. If there's one legal way somewhere that can be used to become wealthy, I will use it. And that was the beginning. I started by buying books. Okay, one of the first books I read at the age of 17 was called Rich Dad, Poor Dad. Powerful book. That book also solidified my faith, because that book showed that you are not poor because you are more educated or you are less educated. That book showed me that it doesn't matter my background. It's not the reason that determines my wealth. And it opened me up to some of the secrets to being wealthy. And one of it was being determined. You just have to make up your mind you want to be wealthy. Let me tell you this. Some people wish to be wealthy, but they are not determined enough. Determination is called deadly dedication. Deadly dedication. Determination also means laser focus. You are not going to be distracted by any. Listen, what people say, you don't care. You don't care what people say. You are focused on your goal of becoming successful. How many of you would enter 2020 with that kind of determination? That if there is any way legally to become rich, I will be rich. If there is a way to become wealthy, I will be among them. Now, others may choose poverty. I choose wealth. They did for me from my village that everybody can make it but except me. No. There was a story of a man in the Bible called Jabez. Jabez, they swear for her. If they said they swear for person, let me speak in broken. They swear for Jabez. His mama can't swear on top. Talk, say, this guy, now sorrow I born him. His name I go name him sorrow. Yeah, boy. This guy was never destined to be wealthy. Jabez was his name. But Jabez got to a point in his life, he got determined that enough is enough. I can't continue this way. I can't continue this way. If there is a way to become successful, I will be. Jabez made up his mind. It didn't matter what people were saying. Oh, yeah, guy. Jabez, that guy, they don't swear for him. Even his mama swear for him. Jabez didn't care. He made up his mind. He failed many times, but he didn't care. Do you know that I've done almost 20 businesses that didn't work?
I was just too determined to give up. Some of you, you know, some of you, when I talk to you sometimes, you start me with this yeye story. You know, it's as if you don't even understand. I've failed so many times. Things have been so difficult. It's almost as if things are... And I'll just be looking at you. You are not determined enough. People are determined, do not even know they are failing. Let me tell you this. There was a story of the man who invented the light bulb. Some people came to him and said, "Oga, you failed to invent light bulb 99 times. I said, "No. I learned 99 ways of not inventing the light bulb. I didn't fail. People who are determined don't see failure. They don't see anything called failure. How many of you are getting value? If you're getting value, can you type, "I'm getting value"? Come on, talk to me, guys. Let's communicate. I don't like this "I do" chat. I want active people. If you are getting value, can you type, "I'm getting value"? Okay, good. We have about 130 people watching us right now. Listen to me, we can get to 500. That is one thing you can do for me to start this, to start 2020. I ended 2019 video, 500 live viewers. Can anybody do that for me? How do you make that happen? Just share this video. At least share it, okay, 10 times. How do you do that? On your right hand side, you see an icon called Facebook Party. Click on that icon and start inviting all your friends. And that way you can do that. Copy the link of this Facebook Live. Paste it on all your Facebook group or your WhatsApp group or your LinkedIn group. Share this video now. I will be grateful if you can do that for me. It will be the delight of my heart. I want to end this year 2019 having 500 people watching me now. Yes, that's how I want to end it. They said that if it takes you too long to get something, your network is poor, right? Now, I believe I have amazing people here. I believe I have great people here. I believe I have wonderful people here. Do me a favor, share this video for me. Some of you can share 20 times. Some of you can even share 50 times. Okay, it won't cost you anything. It's the least you can do for somebody who is teaching you how to become rich, isn't it? It's the least you can do. Guys, we are share. If you have shared this video 20 times, can you signify? Let me know. Okay, share it now. Share this video. So number one thing you need is good. Kennedy is getting value. I'm happy to hear that. Clara is getting value. Chinezo is getting value. Stella, oh, good to know. We have people all over the world. People watching from UK, from Germany, from Russia. Wow. From Lagos, from Abuja, from London. How are you? Good to see you. Thank you, all of you who are watching. So number one thing I use to become rich is determination. I just made up my mind that I will be rich by fire, by force. I don't care what anybody say. I will be rich by fire, by force. And I made up my mind I was going to do everything legally possible. As long as it's legal, I will do it. Do you know this man you are seeing? I sold popcorn. Do you know that? Do you know that this me you are seeing? I've hawked electronics on the street, going with big bag full of electric iron, electric gas cooker. Malaysia is here. Good to see you. All manner. And I was going door to door, house to house. Buy electronics. So I have done all manner. I've pasted poster all across this Lagos. I've trekked all across this Lagos. Right? This me you are seeing. I have trekked. In fact, for your information, I think I've once trekked, yes, from Iyanokpaja to Songwater by leg. So some of you know Lagos very well. You know what I'm talking about. There's nothing I have not been through in this same city. Guess what? In the same Lagos, by the grace of God, I'm owning estates. Yes. Houses, properties. God did it. If he did it for me, he will do it for you. Can I get a big amen? Okay? Come on, let me hear a big amen now. Come on, don't you believe? If God did it for me, he will do it for you. But the number one rule, you have to be determined. This is not an option. This is not what I feel like. This is not like maybe. It is compulsory. Until success become the only option for you, you will not get it. Now, the story I'm going to share under this last point, so that I give you two more points. I want to give you two more points. How many of you are enjoying this? If you're enjoying this type, I'm enjoying this. There was this story of a young man who went to meet a rich man like me and said, "Sir, I want you to teach me how to become wealthy." And the man smiled. He said, "Are you sure?" He said, "Yeah." He said, "Sir, I'm desperate. I want to be rich." Okay? Dangote Olorimeji. Now, I beg, I want to become a billionaire, okay? Like tennis sign, okay? So, the man said, okay, walk with me. Took him to a pool side, to a pool. And then took his head, dipped him inside the pool. True story. After some minutes, he raised his head up. I said, again, young man, what did you say you want? He was gasping for breath. I said, I want to become rich. He dipped his head inside the pool again. You know, this time around a bit longer. You know, and brought his head out again. Said, again, what did you say you want, young man? He was gasping. Sir, I said, I want to be rich. He dipped his head inside the pool. This time around longer. For almost a minute. And brought him out again. Young man, what do you say you want? He said, I want air. He was gasping for breath. The man said, now you got it. Until you want success as badly as the person who wants air, who is dying of breath, you will never get it. He said, until you want success as badly as the person who is gasping for breath, you will never get it. And this is why many people wish to be successful but are never successful. They are not desperate for it. They are not determined for it. They are not seeing it like something they need, like somebody want to breathe the air. Okay? When you are gasping for breath, nothing else matters. You can't think of anything else except for success. Okay? And until you are desperate for it, you won't get there. You won't. It's just how it works. You have to be determined. I want to become successful. I must be successful. Wow, Prince, thank you. Prince has shared this video 20 times. God bless you, Prince. God will make the new year your best year. In the name of Jesus Christ. That the way you honor me, people will honor you. Nations will honor you. Chiwonze Oguzo, you shared this video 30 times. God bless you. You are entering into your year of honor. People will honor you. The same way I've enjoyed honor all over the world. Trust me. If there's one Nigerian that I've enjoyed honor globally, it's Stephen Akintayo. God will cause nations to honor you. The same way you have honor. Because when I ask you to do something and you do it, it's a sign of honor. It's a proof that you respect me. It's a proof that you like me. It's a proof that you honor me. And I will pray the same prayer that men and nations will honor you. Thank you for doing that. Please, everybody watching this, I'd like you to share this video at least 30 times, just like others have done. Share it. How do you do that? On your right hand side, you see an icon called Facebook Party. Click on it and start inviting people. That's just my own end of the year wish. I want us to have 500 people watching me today. That's my wish. I want to end this year having 500 people watching me live on Facebook, because I don't try. Every day I come here, I teach people, I educate people on how to build wealth. I try to help as many people. I've heard so many testimonies. This year alone, I was able to raise more than 100 people more than 10 people who made over 100 million this year. God used me to raise those people. So I've tried. And it's through this same Facebook life. I have tried. The only thing you people too can do for me back, me that have been coming here to teach you, to educate you, to do all, the only thing you can all do for me, right? To even say we appreciate you, Stephen Akintayo. I want 500 people to watch me live now. How do you do that? Just start sharing, right? If you share it 30 times, it will happen. Copy this link, paste it on all your Facebook group, paste it on all your WhatsApp group, paste it on all your LinkedIn groups, okay? And click on that Facebook party icon and just start sharing. Not one, not two, not three, not four, not five. 30 times. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, up to 30 on several groups. If you do that, we hit 500. If everybody, 160 people watching, share it 30 times, we hit, in fact, we hit more than 500. Thank you. God bless you. Prince has shared this 35 times. You see, we are increasing. We are now 180. Can you see? So the more you share, the more we increase to 500. That's my desire. If you can do it for me, I'll be grateful. So, number one, be determined. Number two, be consistent. Let me tell you this. One of the major reasons why people fail is that the day their miracle was supposed to come, they gave up. It is darkest before dawn, ladies and gentlemen. It is darkest before dawn. Many people quit the day their breakthrough was supposed to come. The day they were bringing, let me share you a story of somebody that happened this year. True story. I was thinking of promoting this guy. The day I decided to announce his promotion in the office, true story, I came to the office. I said, well, where is this person? They said, he resigned this morning. True story. May that not be your story. And I hear louder amen. May you not resign the day they were to promote you. Come on, type amen. May you not resign the day they were supposed to promote you. The day your helper is supposed to come with your gift, may you not give up. May that not be the day all the witches in your village gathered over your head and convinced you to give up. The reason why people don't achieve success is that they are not consistent. Today, they do bulk SMS business. Tomorrow, they do real estate. Next tomorrow, they wake up, they do long reach. Upper tomorrow, they wake up, they say they want to become motivational speaker like Stephen Akita. The year after, they wake up and say God has called them to become a pastor and preach the gospel. Another day, they wake up and say, you know what? They saw a revelation that they will be their music career will be bigger than that of Davido or Burna Boy. You know, they just can't be consistent in one thing. And I've seen several people like that. They just can't be consistent. I got here by being consistent. In the last 11 years, I have lost money. Okay? One particular year, I lost over 120 million naira. One particular year, I lost everything, lost my office. One particular year, I got an accountant who cleared the account because then I used to, you know, give signed checks. He took, you know, he just write the entire amount in the account and he cleared everything and he disappeared. I've not seen him till tomorrow. Yes, it happened to me. When some of you begin to tell me your stories of how you have failed, you have not failed like I have done. You don't have any excuse of giving up. You don't. If I start telling you some of my story, you'll be sharing tears. One day I was sharing with somebody some things I've gone through. The person was crying, literally crying. For me, and I was like, why are you crying? She been at my story, not your story. You have no reason to give up. You have no reason to give up. You have no reason, you have no excuse to give up. Just stay there. Stay there. Now here we go die. All that night die. Now here, if you can be consistent, you will make it. It is darkest before dawn. It is darkest before dawn. It is darkest before dawn. Just tell yourself, I will not give up. We will die here. Now here we go die. We will make it. That's the attitude. That's the attitude. I always tell people this. As everybody else has the right to give up on you, but you better not dare give up on yourself. I will enter this one and come and meet you and lash you koboko. If you give up on yourself, how dare you? You want to give up on you? Everybody has the right, but you can't give up on you. Everybody can say your life is messed up. Everybody can say you're a thief. Everybody can say you're a foreigner. Everybody can say you're a scammer. Everybody can say they don't care. Everybody can say you're a devil. Everybody can say you, but you, Abba, you can't give up on you. Are you kidding me? How dare you even contemplate suicide? Surely a pressure, right? Listen to me, as long as you are alive, you can become anybody. You can become anything. Though a tree be cut down at the scent of water, the Bible says it will spring up. It may be cut down, but at the scent of water, you will come up. As long as you are alive, they no burn that devil well. That witch, that wizard, that demon for your village, they no burn them. As long as you are alive. Listen, if you don't die, nothing will feed you. But you are alive. There's nothing you can't become. You just be consistent. Don't give up. Don't give up. Whatever your hands find it to do, do it well. Do it well. Just do it well. Just do it well. Not that today you do this one. Tomorrow you give up. Next tomorrow you start another one. Now part tomorrow. Some of you now already planning how to give up on your current career. In 2020, if they say you, what are you going to do in 2020? That year job I did last year, I won't do it again. Meanwhile, you don't know. that from that year job, maybe there is a plan for a better promotion for you, but you are already giving up. You must not give up this year. You must not. Let me share this story of my younger brother for you. I don't know if you are getting value. If you're getting value, type, I'm getting value. I'm enjoying this. I'm getting value. Come on, guys, talk to me. If you are getting value, can you type, I'm getting value. I'm getting value. Yes. If you are getting value, type, I'm getting value. I'm getting value. I'm getting value. I'm getting value. I am getting so much value. I would like you to do me a favor, guys. My last switch for this year is that we have 500 people watching me live. My name is Stephen Akintayo. For those of you just joining us, I'm Africa's most sought-after investment coach, and I'm sharing with you three powerful secrets that moved me from poverty to wealth, and that you must do that thing that I'm teaching you now. You must do it, okay? But I also have a request for you. I've been teaching you all through this year, 2019, almost every day I came here and I gave value. Do me a favor, you too. Do something for me. Share this video 30 times. I want us to get to 500 live viewers. We've gotten to over 200 watching right now. And I want to thank everybody who has shared this video. God will honor you. God bless you. God reward you. God will raise people to work for you. God will raise nations to favor you. This year, 2020 will be your best year. You take your right. This year, 2020 will be your best year. It will be your year of exceptional progress, promotion, lifting, supernatural breakthrough in the name of Jesus Christ. I am grateful. I am. And I mean that with the whole of my heart. You're taking your next right. I mean it. Thank you, everybody who has shared. God bless you, Rigo. Please keep sharing. Share it 30 times. I want us to get to 500 live viewers. So the first thing I shared was determination. I got to a point where I just became too determined to succeed. And I made up my mind, I will do everything legally possible to make it. The second thing I did was I decided to be consistent. In the last 11 years, I didn't give up. Despite going through a lot, I just decided to be consistent. I remember there was a time we lost, you take your life, we lost everything. And my wife said to me, "Sir, maybe you should consider picking up a job." I said, "This one thing I've made up my mind I'm going to do, entrepreneurship. And I'm not going to give up until I make it in this entrepreneurship." The story, the rest is history today. We lost everything. It was so bad, so that you understand. For a particular day, and my wife straight down. My wife was even pregnant. There was no food in the house for 2 days. That was how bad it was. But I didn't give up on this entrepreneurship journey. I went through a lot. I got debt without borrowing money. I didn't borrow any money. I just got too much people asking for refund. And it was a mess up season of my life. But I didn't quit. I didn't give up. I didn't consider doing something else. The reason why many of you have not built wealth is because as soon as you face one small challenge, you give up. You are not consistent. So number two secret that got me here is consistency. I just decide to stick to one thing. Find one thing you can do. Straight down. Find one thing that you can do for the next 10 years. I was talking to my wife's therapist yesterday. I said, "Do you see yourself doing this for the next 10 years? She said, "Yeah." So I see myself in the next 10 years, I'm still doing the same business. You know why I was asking her? It will help me to be able to help the lady to expand her business. But some of you, you can't even see yourself doing one thing in the next 20 years. You can't find yourself even doing it for the next 2 years, talk less of 20. You have to, Jesus said, this one thing I do. Can you talk about, this, just go straight. This one thing you can hunt so that they open the gate. Yeah, this one. Okay? This one thing I do. That has to be your determination. This one thing, not these 20 things. Not these 50 things, not these 100 things. You have to be consistent, guys. Consistency is the secret of success. Daddy Gio, all these pastors some of you like to abuse, which I won't blame you for abusing them, was sharing how he used to go to Redeem Camp. In fact, there was a particular day he was trying to go to Redeem Camp and there was no one naira to pay for toll gate. The toll gate, he couldn't pay, one naira. That was how bad things was, but he didn't give up. This was a man who was already supposed to be a professor, who even when he was working as a lecturer, was entitled to big house and all of that, cars and all that. Now he decided to carry this so-called Jesus and become Gio, poor Gio, but he didn't give up. He didn't give up. All these people you admire, some of you admire me too, right? I didn't get here by luck. Oh, sorry. Let me bring up my back. I didn't get here by luck. I got here by being consistent, right? The day the thing work, we are there. The day no work, we are there. The day they abuse us, we are there. The day they did abuse us, we are there. The day things work for us, good. The day they just remain there. Today now you struggle to find people committed to one thing for a year. In Nigeria, you struggle to have a staff stay in a company for 2 years. You struggle to have people consistent. And that's the problem. Because the day your breakthrough is supposed to come, if you are not consistent, the day they bring your miracle, you go, like I told you, it was true story. I just said, this person has been consistent. I'm going to do something for the person. I came to the office, asked for the person. They said the person resigned. May that not be your story. Can you type amen? This year we are entering, 2020. The day your miracle is supposed to come, may you not give up that day. I need you to say a big amen to that. Hey, hey, all these people bring me gifts. God bless you. This is another gift I just saw on my table. Okay, all of you have been sending gifts to my office. The Lord will honor you. Please patronize them. I've just been so blessed by people. People I don't even know. They've just been bringing gift and gift and gift and gift. Please help me patronize this person, right? God bless you. I'm grateful. Right, I am grateful to all of you. You've been so kind. This has been a great year for me, and you made it so. You made it happen. Right, I'm grateful to all of you. All of you, I am grateful. Thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you. All of you who just love me, you don't even know me, we've never met. You know, you just love the person of Stephen Akintayo. I am grateful. Thank you. Okay, God bless you, Rugo. But back to the story, you have to make up your mind not to give up, not to give up, no matter what you face. It is darkest before dawn. A lot of time when people's breakthrough is supposed to come, there is this demon that has a way of pushing people away. May that demon not come against you this year. I have seen it happen in many cases. The day people were supposed to be moving to their new level, for whatever reason that day, for whatever reason, that demon just shook them and bring them down. May that not be your story. That this year you'll be consistent. You will stay till all your breakthrough come your way. The third thing that I did, okay, and this is very, very powerful. And don't give up on this. How many of you have been enjoying this? If you have been enjoying this type, I'm enjoying this, I'm enjoying this, I'm enjoying this. Please, I have a request from you all. I want you to share this video 30 times. If you can do 50 times, I don't mind. Can we share this video 50 times? We already have 260 people. Come on. Wow. Thank you, everybody. I am grateful. I am grateful. 260 live viewers. You made it happen. God honor everybody who have shared. Let's go. Well, our goal is 500. We want to hit 500 live people watching right now. Organically, 500 live viewers. Please share this video 50 times if you can, so that we can get to 500 live people. And I want to thank everybody who has been sharing. Some of you have shared many times. Can you tell me how many times you have shared? I want to just appreciate and acknowledge some of you have shared this video many times. Hey, Jiro, Sakede, how are you, my sister? God bless you. You've been a blessing to me this year. God bless you. Please share this video. Share, share, share. Okay, you can click on the right-hand side. You see Facebook party. Click on that icon and invite all your friends. You can also copy this link and paste on all your Facebook group or your WhatsApp group. Eric, come and put on the AC. You know, please share on all your Facebook group or your WhatsApp group or your LinkedIn group. It's just the only request me I have. Like I said to you, I've come every day this year. Virtually every day, I have come here to train you people. Every single day. I've taught on several courses. Udi shared 30 times. God bless you, Udi. I appreciate it. I'm grateful. So one thing you can do for me, I want, my goal is to end 2019
with all my lovers on social media and having as much as 500 people watching me live. That is the goal. Okay, I want to end this year with 500 live viewers on my Facebook call. And so let's share. Some of you have shared 35 times. Blessing Ayoba, may God bless you. Thank you for sharing 35 times, 23 times. Can we continue? Let's share 50 times. Wow. Esther shared 40 times. God bless you. Can we just continue and let's get to 500 live viewers? So number three. How many of you are ready for number three type? I'm ready. If you are ready for number three thing that I did to move from poverty to wealth, you know, in the last 11 years. Let me also say that it wasn't overnight. I didn't become successful overnight. This thing didn't happen like magic, right? I didn't just wake up and I became wealthy. No. All these awards that you are seeing everywhere, they didn't just happen overnight, right? Awards everywhere, right? It took time. It took consistency. That's why I told you about determination. I told you about consistency. Number three, if you're ready, and I think this is a major factor to become wealthy, and I call it consistent hunger for knowledge. Consistent hunger for knowledge. Never stopping to be hungry for knowledge. The reason why many Africans are poor is that we get so complacent. As soon as we have some small change, we think we know it all. As soon as we make some small money, we think nobody can teach us again. As soon as we make some small money, we think we already have it all figured out. We already know everything involved. And that's one of the reasons why people that I have seen have remained poor. There has to be consistent quest for information. Consistent hunger. The people that I call mentor, if you see how I chew their books. You know, I was still telling somebody yesterday, you know, how just last week, Rich Dad Poor Dad is a book I read at the age of 17. Last week, I still read the book again. This is probably my 50th time reading it. I just, consistent hunger for knowledge. I don't get to a point where I feel, okay, you know what, Stephen Akita, we know it all now. Yes, we've gotten there. You see, we have it all covered. We know everything about it and we got it all. No, I just keep at it. Every day I want to learn more. Every day I'm seeking for new information. Every day I'm thinking, how do I get better? How do I become richer? What else do I need to learn? What again didn't I know before? What other book can I buy? What other conferences can I go for? Who is that rich man that is willing to teach me that I can go and connect with? You know, a consistent quest for knowledge. There are two types of intelligence, and everybody should note this and you should write it down. There's something called IQ, and there's something called QQ. Please write it down. IQ and QQ. IQ simply means intelligent quotient. Those are the kind of children that you give birth to. They are naturally intelligent. My daughter is that way. You know, she is too smart than her age. She's three, but she's bold, she's confident, she's intelligent. It's called IQ. As good as IQ is, it's not better than QQ. QQ is better than IQ. What is QQ? Who can tell me the meaning of QQ? Does anybody know QQ? QQ, anybody, if you know QQ type, I know, I type the meaning. QQ is better than IQ. QQ simply means quest quotient. Quest quotient. Quest quotient. I write it down. People with QQ and don't have IQ. I'm also a QQ person. I'm not naturally intelligent. It's now that, you know, because of intensity of QQ, people think I'm intelligent, and I won't say no. But I grew up not being that intelligent. I wasn't the best in my primary school, in my secondary school. I wasn't. Okay? But what happened was that I was hungry for knowledge. I was hungry for information. I was hungry to be better. And this is one of the reasons why you notice that people were first in primary school, first in secondary school. In the university, they become dullards. This is also one of the reasons why you notice that people come out with first class, end up working for people who came out with third class and we pass. Because people who came out with pass felt they were disadvantaged. They felt they didn't have some advantage.
So as a result, they now started going for more information, more knowledge. More, you know, they were hungry, they were going for more information, they were just doing everything to be better people. They were hungry. Meanwhile, those ones who came out with first class felt that, you know what, we are very intelligent. In fact, I came out with first class, we know it, we have the answer. What's the big deal? And before they know it, the person who wasn't intelligent before becomes super more intelligent, end up becoming more intelligent, end up employing the first class person. Because the first class person got more relaxed. It's the same rule. If you got first class, you got a job in oil and gas company. The person who came out with third class couldn't get a job. So he started trekking on the street of Lagos, like me. Started pasting posters, started bulk SMS business. Before you know it, he moved to IT, moved to digital marketing. Before you know it, he moved into real estate. He did his first 100 million, moved to real estate. Before you know it, he's going all over the world. He's expanded his business, he's becoming a multinational. Before you say Jack Robinson, okay? That person with the first class will have to resign his oil and gas company because this man who came out with PAX has now grown a business that is even bigger than most oil and gas businesses. That is usually the story. So make up your mind to have QQ. Be hungry in 2020 for knowledge. Be hungry for information. Be anything that can add value to you, read it. Any seminar that can teach you how to become wealthy, go for it. No matter the cost, God will provide. You change your language from I cannot afford it to how can I afford it. That is one thing that will turn things around for you in 2020. Right? Any man or woman who knows how to become rich and they've done it for themselves. I'm not talking of, because some of you, your biggest problem, all the people that are teaching you, they are poorer than you. How will you, if it's not that it's demonic, how will you choose to have people mentor you who are worse than you? Some of you, for example, the day you have money problem, it's somebody who is poorer than you that you can talk to. And come on, if you know what I'm talking about, type I understand. Come on, type I understand if you understand what I'm talking about. Many of us, the day we have money problem, it's somebody who is poorer than you that you go and start talking to. Hey, see how tough everything is. In fact, my account is so broke, I'm so poor, things are so difficult. If you understand what I'm saying, type I understand. Do you notice that when people have marital problems, the person they go and get counsel on how to make their marriage better is somebody whose marriage is in crisis. Sometimes even the person who has divorced their spouse that you go and seek counsel for when you are having problem in your own marriage. How do some of us think? I don't get it. Some of us, the day we are having problem with our job, is your friend that was sacked last month that you go and talk to. I say, don't mind that, my boss. See the way he talks to me. I think I want to give up. What do you expect the person to say? Oh, God, resign. Resign. That was a mistake me too I made. If I had known, I should have resigned before they sacked me. So, in 2020, make up your mind to locate people who have results and go and meet them. He said, buy wisdom, sell it not. Okay? Use your mouth to say good things like, how can I afford it? I want to build 5 houses this year. Don't say, I cannot afford it. Mm-mm. How can I afford it? In the year 2020, our company wants to launch 20 estates by the end of the year 2020. That's our goal. Right? I am not saying, oh, where will we get the money? That's not my conversation. My conversation, how do we afford it? How do I afford to expand 2020? How do we afford it? That's what's in my brain. Nothing in my brain is thinking anymore. Okay, I cannot afford it. I'm no longer thinking that way. I think, how can I? How can I? And the same way you should be thinking, I'm going to get 100 houses this year. I'm going to get 10 houses this year. How can I afford it? I'm going to be this. I'm going to be. That's what your goal should be. But go and get the information. Don't just be fantasizing. The mistake a lot of people make, and I didn't do that. That's how I became rich. I refused to fantasize. Fantasy is when you want something, but you not do anything to get it. Fantasy is when you want to be rich, but you are not ready to pay the price to be rich. I remember yesterday, I was teaching about a business model, you know, recharge and bill payment business. And then, the cost of that portal is 1.7 million. So I said, I'm going to do discounts. Some people should pay 400,000. Some other people should pay 800,000. Before I know it, someone was saying,
I can't afford that. How do you expect me to afford that? Where do you want me to get that kind of money? You see, his mindset is wrong. It's wrong. He heard that I mentored somebody who made 140 million in the business. How much do you think you were supposed to put in to start such business? Even if you are going to start mechanic business, you need more than 800,000 to start a mechanic shop. So I don't know where people get it wrong. The question should be, how can I afford it? How can I learn how to get it? How can I learn what price, what will it cost me? And how do I afford what it will cost me? That's the attitude for success. Not, oh, I can't afford it. Where do you expect me to get it? How do you expect me to make it? Who, as if, what's my business with you? Is it not your life? Am I the one that will eat the money? If you make 140 million, is it my money? If I had to, I address the guy. I said, what's the meaning of that rubbish? Do I owe you something? I know you from somewhere. Me and you are from the same village. Or I'd be your uncle, or your president, or your senator, or your House of Rep member. So how will I be showing you a business model and be telling you what it will cost you to start the business, and you are telling me, how do you expect me to get this kind of money? Are you kidding me? What would it be my own? My own is to know, okay, I did this business, I made money from it, you two can do it, and this is what it will cost you. Is that not what I'm supposed to do? But you see, when you have the wrong mindset, and that's what we're talking about, when you have the wrong mindset, it's just, I can't afford it. Where do you expect me to get that money? You don't talk that way. Your conversation should be, how do I afford it? The same thing, even in helping people. Some of you may have family members who really need your help, and please help them. I'm not against it. I'm only against when you are not investing money, and you carry all the money you are making and you are giving family members. Something is, we need to come and do deliverance for you. You should come and meet me for deliverance. But you should help people. Nothing is wrong with that. There are sometimes where family members may call you and they need your help. Instead of saying, when do you expect me to get that kind of money? When do you expect? Just say, why not? Call me back in 2 weeks' time. Whatever you can afford, put it in their hands and pray for them. That's what I do. I remember somebody I knew contacted me. He said, Mom, I need some money. I said, why not? Call me, chat me up. I've exhausted my because I have a budget for giving. So all my charity that I help people give to orphan, give to the poor, there's an amount. Once I exhaust it for a month, if you need my help, you have to wait till the end of the next month. So I told her, I said, wait till the end of the next month. The end of the following month, I took 20,000, transferred it, and I sent plenty prayer. The prayer was more than the 20,000. I said, this 20,000 I've sent to you will multiply. In the name of Jesus, God will send you helpers. The rest of the money will show. God bless you. Thank you. Will the person say, I don't try? Oh, yeah, all of you. Oh, no, no, answer me. I don't try. I sent 20,000 out of, is it 50,000? The person say he won't. I don't try. Talk to me now. I don't try. But that's how you do it. But you say, hey, I can't afford it. Hey, when do you expect to get that kind of money? Hey, what? Hey, come on, relax. Relax. Because this year, 2020, you will talk to Mama Olowo. Babo Olowo is your second name. Can somebody type amen? Okay? That this year, okay, will be your own year where your next name will be Mama Olowo, Babo Olowo, right? That will be your new story. Okay? And that's the way the approach should be. It should be an approach where you are hungry for good information that will move your life forward, that will take you to the next level. Go for good information that will take you to the next level. Stop playing victim. I don't know how, I don't know what. Woo, yeah, see my life. See, you have a glorious future and God will take you there. I don't know if you have enjoyed this. If you have enjoyed this, type I've enjoyed this. Come on, talk to me. I don't know if you have enjoyed this morning. Any money, don't. Plenty energy. Again, for those of you just joining us, my name is Steven Akita. I'm Africa's most sought after investment coach. And I've just shared with you 3 things I did that moved me from poverty. In fact, poverty was our next name. When I was born, we used to go, my mother used to borrow money to send me to school. People used to mock us. Our family was just branded the poor family in the entire neighborhood. But God turned my story around. God turned my story around. And I give him all the glory. Silver Ajakaye, I've done several videos. Go to my YouTube. at Stephen Akintayo on YouTube. You see all the videos where I taught you investment opportunities. Go and watch them there. Okay, Stephen Akintayo, go there and watch. Okay, because some of you always ask me questions like this, but you need to know where to go. Okay, I've done several videos on YouTube. They are free. Go and watch them. They will teach you several businesses you can make money from. Okay, also you can follow me on Instagram at Stephen Akintayo and on Twitter at Stephen Akintayo. While on Facebook, this Facebook, because some of you are watching this, you are not yet following me. So you need to like this page now. The name of the page is at Stephen Akintayo TV on this Facebook. We also have at Stephen Akintayo TV on LinkedIn. Okay, so those are the accounts to follow on YouTube and on Facebook, on YouTube and on Instagram is at Stephen Akintayo one word. While on Facebook and on LinkedIn, it has TV attached to it as Stephen Akintayo TV. I just pasted the link. You can follow it right now. Hey, good to know. Oluwakemi says, I'm motivated. I'm happy to know you guys are blessed this morning. So go and follow me right now at Stephen Akintayo on YouTube right now. At Stephen Akintayo on Instagram. At Stephen Akintayo on Twitter. At Stephen Akintayo TV on Facebook and on LinkedIn. Like my page. Follow me on LinkedIn. And I see you learn a lot from. I've done more than 1,000 videos on different businesses you can do. Go and learn. And they will change your story forever. I love you all. I want to thank every one of you who have contributed to my success in the year 2019. How did you do it? You shared my video. It's part of it. Some of you said some positive things about me to some people. I'm grateful. Some of you patronized our company. You bought property from our company. You bought my books. You bought my video courses. I thank you. Some of you refer people to our company to do business with us. I thank you. Some of you prayed for me in your private space. No, I didn't even see you. I thank you. Some of you bought me gifts like this. I've gotten several of these kind of gifts this year. I thank you. I'm grateful. Eshego, the Lord will lift you up. The Lord will bless you. Good things will come your way. What they practice in Africa is crap mentality. When one person is going up, we try to bring him down. But many of you on this call, you have lifted me up. You didn't bring me down. Many of you said good things about me. You attempted, you did everything in your power to lift me up. And I'm grateful. I am grateful. And I say thank you for doing that. Thank you for doing that. God will lift you up. God will raise men. In your day of trouble, God will send you helpers. God will send you defenders. Some of you have defended me where I couldn't defend myself. I was not even there. But you defended me. Just said, this guy, I believe him, I trusted him, I know he's legit, I know he's real, he's not like other people. Thank you, I'm grateful. Some of you fought some people on my behalf, you fought them. I say, if you're going to talk about Stephen this way, I don't want to be your friend again. I thank you. Some of you are insulted because you know me, because you chose to be my friend. I thank you. Some of you got, oh, I mean, thank you. I just say thank you for everything. Thank you. Thank you. The three things I shared today that moved me from poverty to wealth. Number one was determination. I got to a point of my life where I was tired of giving excuses. I just made up my mind, I must succeed. I was determined to succeed. Number two thing that I did that moved me from poverty to wealth was consistency. I just said to myself, I'm not going to give up. I'm not going to start this and quit, start and quit, start and stop, start and stop. Once I pick up something, I will see to the end. If I made up my mind, I will no longer be picking up things that I'm not ready to see to the end. I became consistent. In the last 11 years, I've been doing the same thing in 11 years, not giving up. My personal business that I started was one of the business I started with. I'm still doing it today. Consistency is the key. Number three thing, okay, was hunger for information, hunger for knowledge that can change my life. Some of you have hunger for gossip. Some of you have hunger for bad news. The day they said there's accident in Mowo Ofada, you are the first to want to hear it. The day they said somebody died of cancer, you are interested. Me, I'm not interested. I am hungry for good news. I am hungry for positive information. I am desperately hungry for good information. I'm this guy that is hungry for knowledge, always hungry to learn, always hungry to learn what will help me be better, always hungry to learn how to become wealthy, always hungry to learn businesses I can do, always hungry to learn how I can change somebody's life, always hungry to learn how I can be bigger, better. I am hungry for success. And that is the secret. Hungry for the information that will show me how to make it. Some of you are not. The day will tell you, oh, I have something that can help you become, make 100 million. It will cost you 1 million. Where do you want me to get it? Where? How? Who is it? Instead of you will say, how can I afford it? Okay, and work on your mind to say, how can I afford it? In your mind, you see, once you tell your mind, how can I afford it, it will begin to give you strategies. But once you just say, where do you want me to get it? How? Where? I can't afford it. You shut it down. So for me, I leave that attitude. Every year, I spend more than $100,000 to educate myself. I already have my PA sign up for one of the courses I'm going for next year. It's $30,000. One course, $30,000. One course, $30,000. Hungry for knowledge. Hungry. For information. And don't say, oh, it's because I have the money. I started when I did have money. I started as a student. My mother would send me 10,000 naira. Sometimes I use 5,000 to go and to buy books, to go for one seminar. Sometimes I would spend the entire 10,000 and I would start cooking up another story to my mom to send me another money. True story. I was hungry for knowledge since I was a student. That's how I got here. You want to move from poverty to wealth, do the same. And I promise you, these three powerful principles will get you there. I love you all. Thank you for being part of my joy this year. Thank you for adding value. Thank you for being part of my story. Thank you for being part of my success. I love you. Because some people like when you are failing, right? Some people are jealous, even watching successful people. You are not. And that's why I know that in 2020, you will prosper by fire, by force. Because you have wished me well, I wish you well too. Because you have desired good things for me, good things will locate you in the name of Jesus. A lot of people who come on social media to watch successful people and the first thing they want to do is criticize them, bring them down, say all manner of bad things about them. But you are not one of such. You come here every day, you make me feel welcome, you share how I'm adding value to your life. I know you are next in line for breakthrough. I love all of you. And thank you all for watching, and God bless you. Happy New Year. Happy New Year. Happy New Year. And everybody watching me, you will see January 1st, 2020. And you see January 1st, 2021. In the name of Jesus. Between the few hours remaining for this year to end, you will not die. No evil will snatch you. In Jesus' name. I love you all. Bye-bye. Bye-bye. All right.